Welcome to Business 204, Business Statistics. I'm your instructor, Annie Ngo, and in this video, I'll provide an overview of the course and a tour of our Canvas site. So here we are on our homepage, and the way I've set it up, there are some quick links that you'll typically navigate to in our course. At the start of each week, you'll want to click on the Announcements button for the weekly updates, but know that on Monday mornings, I send out an email that will let you know what to expect each week. Additional announcements are released throughout the week via email and the announcements page based on student inquiries or any updates to the course. To access the module each week, you'll click on the weekly modules button here, or you can click on the modules link on the left side of the screen. Make sure to check the calendar and the coming up sections of Canvas. So the calendar can be found here on the left, and on the right over here is the coming up or the to-do list in Canvas. Quick access to the syllabus and the research project are also available here. If you ever notice an issue with a Canvas link or a file in our course, please let me know so I can fix it. Let's take a quick look at the syllabus. So if I click here, in Canvas, the course syllabus provides the high-level components. Here's the intro to the course, my contact info, and I do recommend clicking on this link here, which will let you download the full copy of our syllabus and all of its information. If you continue to scroll down, a few more details include the course description, course details, course objectives, and student learning outcomes. And if you scroll all the way down, we have our course summary. So I make sure that everything in our course is already set up fully, so you can see everything that is going to occur throughout the semester. If you ever notice an error or issue in the dates between Canvas or our syllabus, please let me know. Let's go ahead and go back to the home page. We'll go ahead and click on the weekly modules button. And so what you'll see here in our first module is actually our course orientation and resources module. So I try to provide everything you need to be successful in this course right here. I recommend going through it now, but you'll likely reference this module throughout the semester when you have a question or get stuck on something. If you scroll down, you'll notice the next module is related to our research project based on Airbnb data for the semester. So to make sure you're successful, I've broken up the assignment in multiple parts. So in certain weeks of the course, you'll be working on a component of the project. For convenience, I do have everything together in one module for easy access. And if you continue to scroll down, you'll notice that I have some external resources that you might be interested in. These resources are related to business statistics, some math skills, as well as some Excel tutorials. Then, if you continue to scroll down, you'll see that I do have week one and week two modules open already. The layout of the module guides you through each activity of the week that you should be doing. Let's go ahead and look at the course orientation and resources module in depth, and I'm just going to be clicking through these links. So here's the first link in the module. This is our welcome page, and it provides a welcome on the course and an announcement regarding our optional orientation at Oceanside in room OC4803A on Wednesday, August 21st from 4:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. So for those students who would like to meet face-to-face with me and your peers, we'll be talking about things like our MyLab Stats homework, we'll do a meet and greet, talk about the syllabus, the research project, and any general questions you might have on the course. Attending the orientation is worth 5 extra credit points. Otherwise, these topics will be covered in writing or through videos on Canvas for everyone, even if you cannot attend the orientation. I also have some links here to some Canvas tutorials if you need a refresher, or perhaps this is the first time you've worked in Canvas. On this page has my information. It's got my contact info, office hours, my teaching philosophy, and background. I really encourage you to come see me during my office hours as it can help you succeed in this course and make things go much more smoothly. You can also schedule office hours through Zoom and we can meet virtually. So here I'm available on Mondays and Wednesdays from 12 to 1:30 p.m. in OC4810 and on Tuesday and Thursday mornings from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. in the same office. I also have a link to my YouTube channel, so all of our lecture videos and Excel tutorials can be found here. If I click Next, here I have our weekly expectations summarized. While this is an online course, I do not record 2.5-hour long lectures. Rather, I provide short videos on various concepts and interactive tutorials that you can follow along using a practice problems worksheet and Excel files that I provide. So the general structure for each week includes reading the assigned chapter, then watching the lecture videos, and I provide slides in PDF so you can take notes on it. I also include how-to video tutorials using Excel. There's a small group discussion board with original posts due Thursdays at 11 p.m. and at least one peer post due on Sundays at 11 p.m. These are worth 10 points, 5 for your original post and 5 for your peer post. Each week there's a reading quiz, and they're conceptual in nature, but you'll also see them on the exams. You get 2 tries with the highest score recorded, and your lowest quiz score of the semester gets dropped. Each week you also have a MyLab Statistics homework assignment with somewhere between 6 to 10 homework questions. These are due on Sundays at 11 p.m. and are worth 20 points per assignment. Note that the homework also includes a lecture video check-in question that asks you about some specific content in the video to ensure that you're watching them, and that's worth 1 point. Some weeks of the semester have additional assignments related to our research project. My assignment deadlines and late work policy is as follows. Quizzes and MyLab Stats homework have a 2-day grace period, meaning I don't bug you and there's no questions asked, you don't need to contact me about it, no penalties, just take the 2 days you need. Sometimes students need it because they're waiting for me to respond to a question, or life happened and your weekend was busy, or you're just waiting for an appointment with a tutor. So take those 2 days if you need it. If you're still having trouble completing these individual assignments, please come see me during office hours or email me for help. Note that research project assignments are late if submitted after the due dates listed in the course schedule. Please contact me before an assignment is due if you have extenuating circumstances and need an extension. I am much more accommodating when we collaborate together. Here are the netiquette rules for our course. Please read through these and let me know if you have any questions at all. Here's the required textbook and MyLab registration instructions. I recommend buying the loose leaf textbook with access code to MyLab Statistics from the MiraCosta bookstore. Do not buy from Amazon, as it won't have our unique access code to MyLab Statistics. Alternatively, if you don't need the loose leaf textbook and are trying to be green, you can order the ebook with access code, which is a few dollars cheaper using the instructions below. If you're not sure about the course, I recommend taking advantage of the 14-day free trial for access to all materials. There are no refunds after you buy the book. Once the trial is over and you've decided to stay in the course, you can purchase the book with access code and then just enter your code in to the system and everything will sync up. Please note that access to the text is required by the first week of class to complete the assignments. What's very important is also the required technology of the course. You need a calculator and access to a computer with internet and Excel. I've had some students try to take this course without Excel, and it is a struggle because the majority of the statistical analyses we do in this course are in Excel. So you can either purchase Microsoft Office for PC or Mac for $39.99 using this link here, where you'll just have to provide them a copy of your course schedule as proof that you're a student. Alternatively, you can use computers at the MiraCosta Library, both San Alejo and the Oceanside campuses, or you can click on this link here, which will let you virtually access MiraCosta's computers, which have Excel. There's a bit of a learning curve on how to virtually use the computer, and it's a bit slower, but it does work. You can also use StatCrunch, which is a tool in MyLab Statistics, but I don't teach with it because in business, companies don't use or even know about StatCrunch. They use Excel. Another option is that you can check out a laptop from the MiraCosta Library for 7 days, but you do have to wait 24 hours between checkouts. If you scroll down, here are the instructions to register for MyLab Statistics. Please note that Safari browsers do not work well with the system and you should be using Chrome or Firefox. Please make sure that when you're working on MyLab Statistics that you are entering through Canvas and not the publisher website. In addition, do not register directly through the publisher website. Use the instructions here on how to register through Canvas, which links to MyLab Stats. I also have a video here on how to register, but the instructions are written here as well. Like any system, MyLab Stats has pros and cons. Here are some helpful tips to succeed on the homework that I've compiled over the years based on student feedback and my own experience with the tool. read through these and let me know if you have any questions. I've also got a video at the bottom here that'll walk you through some of these tips. Here are the instructions to add VMware and Excel Data Analysis Toolpack. So as I mentioned before, the VMware is where you'll be able to virtually access MiraCosta's computers if you don't have Excel at home. And the Data Analysis Toolpack is a component within Excel that you have to turn on in order to run the complex statistical analysis we'll be doing throughout the semester. I include these instructions in each week's module on the chapter resources page at the bottom. I also have a page on MiraCosta's tutoring, workshops, and help desks that are available. I always recommend coming to see me during office hours if you need help, but if you prefer to work with a tutor, the Math Learning Center is a great resource, and they have access to our Excel course materials. Here is also a link to the publisher's help desk, but you can also contact them while you're in the MyLab homework system under the help menu. Clicking next. I also have a page on advice from past students. This will help you navigate the course successfully as it relates to things like homework, vocab, technology, quizzes and exams, etc. And if you're really curious, I have all of the advice from several semesters. What you see here on the screen is just from last semester. Clicking on next. Here's the extra credit opportunity for attending the optional orientation I mentioned before on August 21st at 4:30. It is worth 5 points, which I'll enter into the gradebook after you attend. Here's another extra credit opportunity I'm letting you know in advance. It's a newspaper article analysis where you'll pick an article that has some statistical data, and you can earn up to 20 points by addressing each of the 4 bullets here, with each bullet worth 5 points. If you have any questions, just let me know. Another extra credit opportunity is attending an accounting and business club meeting and doing a short write-up of what you learned. I'll post more information on these meetings once they become available, and pizza is available at most meetings. At the end of each module, there's an end of module page to let you know you finished the module. There's a quick link to my contact info if you need to reach out to me, and a quick link back to our homepage. So looking at the week one module, the first thing you'll notice is a link to the video that you're watching now, followed by our first discussion board. You'll be introducing yourself to the class. I've also included the required textbook and MyLab stats registration information page again, in case you forget, as well as a PDF version of Chapter 1 in case you want to read it before you get your book. The next link here is the Chapter 1 resources. This is where I've got all my lecture videos posted for you. And so after you finish reading a chapter, you'll see that I have videos on the concepts for the chapter and a PDF version of the slides. For most chapters, but not the first few, there is a practice problems worksheet available that you can use to follow along with the videos. Go ahead and click next. You can see here's our reading quiz, which is open book, untimed, with 2 tries. And then if I click next again, it'll take you to the homework tips because I want to remind you to review them before starting on the homework. And then if you click next again, you'll see a link to the homework for Chapter 1, which will get unlocked shortly. And it will require you to click on a button to open up in a new tab. So once it becomes available and you click on the box, it will appear in your browser and then you can do the homework. So here's the end of week one module with a link to my info and a link to the homepage. And then here, as you can see in week two's module, it's structured very similarly. There's a link to the chapter 2 resources, which has all the video lectures and PDF slides, a link to our discussion board, the quiz, the homework, and the end of week 2 module page. So if you have any questions, just let me know.